everybody. Please, I thank you for giving me this opportunity. Today for me is a day that Nigerian women all over the world should celebrate, because this is one step that will lead us to any level as far as women inclusion is concerned. A few hours ago, the House passed a bill for an act to alter the provisions of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, 1999, to create additional special seats for women in the National Assembly and State House of Assembly. And I believe that because of the number of people that sponsor and co-sponsor this bill, that I need to let you have all the full brief, because at the plenary we could not say anything. We couldn't say everything because of time. And so I know that you're my brothers and my sisters, and I know that you have mothers. Some of you have wives. Some, of course, everybody will marry. Abby? Almost everybody, except the Reverend Fathers. But of course, even the Reverend Fathers, they have mothers. So I believe that women, I believe that women matters. Hello?
Hi.
Women matters. And that's why I am happy that you're obliging me to let you into the details of this bill that was passed for second reading. You know, after second reading, then that's when the journey starts. And I want you people to be on our side. Because if you want this bill to die, just let press be against it. So I'm coming to lobby the press. In-house, this is lobby, and lobby is allowed. Even in America, there's lobbyists, you understand? And it's approved by law. So now I have come to lobby my friends, my brothers and my sisters, so that give this bill a positive look. Because the economic benefit outweighs everything negative anybody would say. For instance, anywhere you put a woman, without conceding to certain negativities, you expect results, unless the woman did not agree wholeheartedly to be part of it. And so when we ask that women should be included in political space, we are asking for more deliverables to our constituents. We are asking for more representation. We are asking for more input on the things that will touch life of an average family member. Because if you have a small baby, a baby girl, after 2 years, she will start learning how to cook, how to mold, how to do a lot of things. You understand? But the men, for 2 years, will carry ball and go outside to start playing. You understand? So the girl starts from early life to learn how to build, how to take care. It's nature. And of course, the Bible says that a woman, Adam, I'm giving you a woman, I remove a rib to make a woman so that you become a help mate. And what it simply means is that the man can't do it alone. If God himself did that, so please, I beg that we should support, that we join the rest of the world to support inclusion of women in all spheres of life, especially in political life. If you have more women, you have less thuggery. If you have more women, you have less corruption. I say it with all sense of honor and humility, because our wants and our needs are very limited. No woman will marry four husbands, okay? And if a man has more than one wife, you must care for them, because even God himself says you must care for everybody and love everybody the same. The way you love number one is the way you're going to love number two, number three, number four. But a woman will just know one husband. All the four wives no only one husband. You understand? So they work for one man. So in that way, if you give the woman an opportunity, the woman will just care for one and then children. And you know that women are more communal based. Every woman will want to go home. But a man can fall in love and then pick race. I've been a lie. These ones are off record. Just to tease you to be on my side. You understand? So, the bill is sponsored by me, the Speaker of House of Representatives, because our Speaker is a he for she person. And of course, he slated out few days, just last week, to discuss on gender issues. And I can tell you, this is first time a Speaker of House of Representatives. I've been here for 10 years. This is my fourth time. Would say all the female legislators should be members of Constitutional Review. It has never happened. At least it didn't happen in 6th Assembly. It didn't happen in 7th Assembly. It didn't happen in 8th Assembly. But the Speaker graciously included all the women, irrespective of which zone you come from. And you know that Constitutional Review, they share it according to geopolitical zones. After state, you share it according to zones on special allocation. But he didn't care. So even if one zone is bringing these 12 women in parliament, that all of them should get it. Even when he met strict resistance from some people, he said, no, all the women. So he is co-sponsoring this bill. Honestly, I'm so humbled when he said, it's not just supporting this bill, but I am a co-sponsor, I will sponsor it. And let me tell you, this is the first time I've been in the House for 12 years, 13 years, that my male colleagues from the North wholeheartedly signed to this bill. The day I took round, I got 70-something signatures just from the North. So that means that 9th Assembly is exceptional. We've been bringing this type of bills over in 6th Assembly, 7th Assembly. By the time you start introduction, they will shut it down. You people that have been here for a while are witnesses to these things happening over the years. And so, all the female members are co-sponsors. All the women are sponsoring the Beast Bill. And I can say majority of the men are in support. The chief whip is from Borno. He's a Muslim. He's signed to this bill. The minority leader signed to this bill. Deputy minority leader signed to this bill. Honorable Magaji, chairman of power, signed to this bill. Former deputy minority leader of Southeast, from Southeast, Chuchu Onyema, signed to this bill. So I can go on and on, on and on. So from the parliament, we have accepted to let this bill work. But now, from you people that will help package it to the outside world, outside this parliament, I'm seeking for your support to help us make sure that this bill gets positive response from the public. And before 1999, you are all aware that the House of Representatives was about 400 and something then, and 5 senators per state. So when people argue about increasing the number or whatever, it wouldn't hold water, because before now we experienced it before. So it's not something that's very unusual. So the bill is comprised of 6 major clauses that seeks to alter Section 48, Section 49, Section 71, Section 77, Section 91, and Section 117 as set out below. Number 1, alteration of Section 48. Section 48 of the Principal Act is altered by substituting the existing Section 48 with a new Section 48. 48 composition of the Senate. The Senate shall consist of 3 senators from each state and 1 from the Federal Capital Territory. B, an additional senator for each state and for the Federal Capital Territory, who shall be a woman. That's the amendment we're seeking. Then number 2 of the section, nothing shall prevent a woman from contesting for any of the senatorial seats referred to in subsection 1A. 3, this provision of subsection 1B shall commence after the current life of the National Assembly and shall be reviewed after 16 years. Some people are proposing 20, 13 years, but for this bill, we are saying 16 years from its commencement, notwithstanding any other provision of this Constitution. Then number 2, alteration of Section 49. Section 49 of the Principal Act is altered by substituting the existing Section 49 with a new Section 49. Section 49, composition of the House of Representatives. Remember, 48 talks about the Senate. 1, subject to the provision of this Constitution, the House of Representatives shall consist of 360 members representing constituencies of nearly equal population as far as possible, provided that no constituency shall fall within more than 1 state. And B, 2 additional members of each state and for the Federal Capital Territory, who shall be women. 2, notwithstanding the provision of subsection 1 of this section, nothing shall prevent a woman from contesting for any of the seats in the constituencies, referred to in subsection 1A, which is the 360. 3, the provision of subsection 1B shall commence after the current life of the National Assembly and shall be reviewed after 16 years from its commencement, notwithstanding any other provision of this Constitution. 3, alteration of Section 71. Section 71 of the Principal Act is altered by inserting immediately after subsection 1A and B, new subsections 2 and 3. Section 71, senatorial districts and federal constituencies. 1, subject to the provision of Section 72 of this Constitution, the Independent National Electoral Commission shall A, divide each state of the Federation into 3 senatorial districts for purpose of election of the Senate. B, subject to the provisions of Section 49 of this Constitution, divide the Federation into 360 federal constituencies for purpose of elections to the House of Representatives. 2, for the purpose of Section 48 of this Constitution, a state shall constitute an additional senatorial seat to be occupied by a woman. 3, for the purpose of Section 49 of this Constitution, the Independent National Electoral Commission shall divide each state of the Federation into 2 federal constituencies to be occupied by women. Number 4, alteration of Section 77. Section 77 of the Principal Act is altered in subsection 1 by substituting the words every senatorial district or federal constituency in lines 1 and 2 with the words every senatorial district federal constituency and the additional seats. Section 77, direct election and franchise. One, subject to the provision of this constitution, every senatorial district, federal constituency, and the additional seats established in accordance with the provisions of this part of the chapter shall return one member who shall be directly elected to the Senate or the House of Representatives in each manner as may be prescribed by an act of the National Assembly. Section 117 of the Principal Act is altered in, please let me take that again. Number six, alteration of section 117. Section 117 of the Principal Act is altered in subsection one by inserting immediately after the word every state constituency in line one, the words and the additional seats. Section 117, direct election and franchise. One, subject to the provision of the Constitution, every state constituency and the additional seats established in accordance with the provisions of this part of this chapter shall return one member who shall be directly elected to a House of Assembly in such manner as may be prescribed by an act of the National Assembly. My respected gentlemen of the press, women has only 4.4% representation in the 9th National Assembly. You may wish to know that Nigeria has been identified as the worst performer in women representation in parliament, in the West African region, and one of the lowest in the whole Africa. This is evidenced in the most recent Inter-Parliamentary Union at IPU ranking of women in parliament, where Nigeria ranks 179 out of 187 countries worldwide. Eritrea is the only African country ranked lower than Nigeria, and this is because there have not been national elections since its independence in 1993. The situation is worse at the state houses of assembly level, where a good number of our states do not have a single woman in their state assembly. In some of these states, men chair the Women Affairs Committee because there is no woman available to take that office. Currently, more than 130 countries have adopted some type of special measure or quota system to address women's underrepresentation. Over 75% of these cases were introduced in the last 20 years, particularly since year 2000. Strikingly, the majority of nations that have adopted special measures, quota system, are low or middle income countries, many of them in Africa. A very good example is South Africa, where the introduction of quotas in the 1994 election by the African National Congress, ANC party, resulted in 27% of women in their very first democratic election. Currently, South Africa has 46.5% women in the lower chamber and is one of the top 10 countries for women in parliament. Rwanda is the world leader in women's political participation with 49% of women in their lower chamber. This followed from deliberate constitutional efforts taken to include women in government to foster rebuilding of the country post-genocide in 2003. That's 2003. Even conservative countries are beginning to realize the usefulness of political inclusion of women. For instance, women in countries such as Egypt, Iraq, Jordan, Mauritania, Morocco, the state of Palestine, and Tunisia have successfully lobbied for the introduction of various measures, such as electoral quotas, to increase and strengthen women's political representation. Between 2010 and 2017, the majority of countries in the Arab region have seen an increase in the representation of women in their parliament. In 2013, it may also interest you to know that for the first time, 30 women were appointed to Saudi Arabia's Shura Council, that's advisory body, representing 20% of seats as of 2021. In Algeria, the proportion of female members of parliament tripled from 8% to 32%, in line with a quota introduced in 2012. In Afghanistan, women now make up about 27% of the upper and lower houses of parliament, and we are active in drafting the country's new constitution. This was facilitated by a male president who signed and supported declarations of women's rights, and in 2005, appointed the first female governor. Our West African neighbor, Senegal, adopted a party law in their constitution in 2012. This was facilitated by the then president, Abdoulaye Wade, and resulted to an almost 50-50 balance between men and women in the Senegalese parliament. Nigerian, because it has been allotted for women according to constitution, because we've lobbied all over. I remember in 6th Assembly, I was a member of Constitution Review. We went to Calabar. We lobbied all our men. May God bless his soul, Honorable Bethel Amadi, who was our he for she then. So he followed us, campaigned with us, I with Betty Apiafi and few others. Lobbied the men that we traveled to Calabar for Constitution Review Committee. And then he seems hopeful that he spoke to them, because what we were asking then was political party inclusion, not elective positions. Like, for instance, if you have a national chairman, let a woman be the vice. If you have a secretary, let a woman be the vice.
Thank you.